Mr. Harris is a motivational speaker, author, comedian, educator, and entertainer. During comeback season and recharge season, he gave us two outstanding speeches that helped us to get our inner fires going. If we're receptive, today's speech can help take each of us to the new levels of reaching our destiny as well. Please show your love for Mr. James Harris as he takes the stage, Information versus Transformation.
All right, let's go. I need it. Are y'all feeling good tonight? Okay, all right. I once heard a story told to me about the duck preacher. Now, he's a duck, quack, 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 right? But he's also a preacher. Good Lord, Lord, right? He's from the east side. I can say that. He goes from town to town spreading the good news, and one day he stumbles upon a town filled with ducks, a duck town. He goes to the local church, and he steps on stage, and there's a hush before he begins. And he looks at him and says, "You are ducks. You have wings, and you can fly." And the ducks say, What? He says, "I don't think you heard me. I said, you are ducks. You have wings, and you can fly." And the ducks say, Yes, I want you to say it with me. "We're ducks. We're ducks. We have wings. We have wings, and we can fly. We can fly." And the ducks say, Oh, yeah, Lord, help me. Now, after the sermon is over, the ducks put on their jackets, and they walk home. Don't miss that. How many times has it been you where you wake up in the morning, "I can do this, I have greatness, I have potential," and then can't creeps in. Doubt drags you down. You were gonna lose weight and all you did was wait around. And people ask me, "Well, why is it that the ducks knew they had wings, they knew they could fly, and they still decided to walk home?" The reason people do this is because they stop at information and they do not move towards their transformation. Right? People stop at the information of knowing, "I have wings, I can fly, I can do all things, I have greatness." You stop at the information of knowing, and you do not move towards the transformation of your growing. And this is not information season. This is... No, I need some power with it. This is... Yeah. And if you want to be transformed, there are three questions I want to help you answer tonight. The first question is, how do you move from informed to transformed? The second question is what you see what you are? And the third question I want to help you answer tonight, if you want to grow, what are you willing to let go? Is that all right? Here we go. How do you move from informed to transformed? Well, what does it mean to be informed? Informed is just knowing things for the sake of knowing them, right? Just knowing things. Informed is knowing that what goes up must come down. Okay, all right. Informed is knowing that 2 + 2 = 4. Okay, I got some math majors in the house tonight. All right, I appreciate y'all coming out, right? Informed is knowing that the powerhouse of the cell is the... I got some nerds in the house tonight. Give the nerds a round of applause. I knew they would be here with me. You know it, but do you use it? Do any of you actually use knowing about the powerhouse of the cell being the mitochondria to become a better person or to walk out of a toxic relationship or to chase your dreams? I mean, you know it, but you don't use it. Therefore, you know it, but it has no use. Tonight, I want you to consider that information is knowing, but transformation is growing. Watch this. Information is knowing about the human genetic code of DNA, just knowing about DNA. But being transformed is knowing that your DNA does not decide your destiny. You are not your past. Say that again. You are not your past. Say that again. You are not your parents. Informed is knowing that a caterpillar will one day become a butterfly. But being transformed, oh my God, being transformed is being that caterpillar and knowing that one day you're going to be amazing, even though you've never done it before, even though your friends say, "I can't see that working out." I mean, logically, a caterpillar should just grow into a larger caterpillar. Scientifically speaking, right, it should just grow into a big old worm. How does that happen? from caterpillar to butterfly, it does not make sense. It should not be possible. But what about you? Information says that you came from poverty, or that you were abused, or everyone you trusted betrayed you. Your best friends walked out on you. The teachers gave up on you. Your parents walked out on you. You faced sexism or racism. They said you were meant to go to jail or prison, and they said they just gave up on you. Many of you in this room have been very well informed your entire life, but look at you now. Look how amazing you are. It's okay. You can give yourself a round of applause for that. Look at the information you took and the transformation you have now. You did go to college. You got that job. You got that scholarship. You changed the narrative of your life. You beat the sexism. You beat the racism. You found the cure to your own hardship. You beat your anxiety. And then you got back up and you beat your depression. And people will say, how did that happen? Your coworkers whispering, he wasn't supposed to get that job. Your people at school, she got it. She thinks she's cute because she got an A. Right? She wasn't supposed to. People will judge you. They'll look at the information of your life, where you went to school, the side of town you grew up on, the friends you had, the parents you had. They look at the information of your life and they see the beautiful things that you're becoming right now, and it does not make sense. And I'm saying, I want you to leave your haters confused. Our major question tonight was, how do you move from informed to transformed? To do this means you're changing the narrative of your life. Think about that. It's a rewrite. Now, when you rewrite your life, you can't change the characters. I mean, you can't change who your parents and you can't change the setting. You can't change where you grew up. But when you change your life, you move from informed to transformed, you get to decide a new outcome. Even when this show is over, you get to decide what happens next. I'll prove it to you. A girl wants to be a chef. Her parents got divorced. The end. Is this a good story? No, I mean, but she wanted to be informed. She wanted to be a chef. Her parents got divorced. The end. Something's missing, right? Let's see it again. A young girl wants to be a chef. Her whole life, she watched her parents make these amazing meals, and they would bring everybody, her big family, together into the kitchen to make these amazing meals. Now, sometimes there were times that were just rough. There were hard times. Money was low. She remembers her parents arguing and fussing and fighting. There were times when she had to sleep in her closet just to hide from the noise. But she reflected on her life. She said, the only time that I was happy when my parents were together in the kitchen making these meals. I saw my parents loving each other, holding each other. We were dancing. We were just enjoying each other's company. That's when I felt loved. Years later, she decided the real reason she should become a chef is to create those same moments for other families. She knew that, yes, there are broken families dealing with hardship and divorce, but if she could just get them into her restaurant, she could make them feel whole. And she knew that she could transform others. Now what story is better? Transformation, right? Transformation. Transformation, how do you move from informed to transformed? It's taking the information, taking the ingredients of your life and remixing it. Information is bland, but when you transform your life, you take in your life story and put in some seasoning, put in some salt. Putting some flavor. I mean, no wonder your ex keeps giving you salty looks. Somebody needed to hear that. They're over here. How do you move from informed to transformed? You take your mess and you make it majestic. You take your disease or your diagnosis or whatever the doctor says you have and you use it for your destiny. Being transformed says, I'm going to take my fears and my faults and my failures and use them as my foundation and build up from my lowest point. Random. I have a pencil here. Now, if I break this pencil, what happens? Yeah. Information says that it's broken. Throw it away. Information says that it's damaged. Throw it away. People in this room, some of you really think that something that is damaged, something that is broken, something that has flaws is ugly, and you throw it away. Some of you have done that with your lives. But a transformed person will say, no, don't throw that pencil away, because if I take that pencil and I sharpen it, it still has value, it still has use. You are more valuable than this pencil. You are more valuable than this pencil. And even when you feel broken, even when you feel damaged, even if you think you have flaws, you are not ugly. Do not throw your life away. Keep writing your story. Keep writing your story. A broken pencil can be sharpened. A broken person can be transformed. But watch this. Let me go deeper. When I broke the pencil, right, threw it away. The part that left the pencil didn't stop it from writing. Did you see that? The people that leave you, the people that walk out on you, the people that hope to leave you abandoned, some people will just try to break you with goodbye. And I'm saying, keep writing your story. Keep writing your story. Decide to stay sharp. I mean, don't you see the point? How do you move from informed to, you'll catch it later. How do you move from informed to transformed? You create a new narrative for your life, and you use what was meant to break you, shape you into your greatness. Question number two, is what you see what you are? Think about that. Is what you see what you are? When you look in the mirror, what do you see? See a doctor, a lawyer, entertainer, physicist, teacher, educator, best friend? What do you see? Now, I'm not asking what do other people see in you. Well, because see, my mama say I'm good at robotics. On my mama's side, because see, we're going to be an engineer. Because see, she was telling, no, boo, what do you see in yourself? What do you see in yourself? And I wonder if you look in the mirror, if what you see determines who you can be. If you looked in the mirror and you saw a dog, you literally saw yourself as a dog, I bet you just start barking. My fault. My cow, my fault. Yeah, boss, my fault. School, teacher, my fault. Everybody's saying, why is he acting that way? Because he sees himself as a dog. He started doing dog things. You see yourself as a dog, I bet you start hanging with dog people. That was too far, I apologize. I bet if you look in the mirror and you saw yourself as worthless or stupid or no purpose or dumb, I bet you started living your life that way. And I'm just asking, is what you see what you are? How many of you have been to a fun house at a carnival? When you go to a fun house, they have these large bending mirrors that warp and distort your true appearance, right? They make you look shorter, taller, bigger, fatter, skinnier. You just look crazy. And if all you had were these mirrors, you start to think, oh my God, I look stupid. You look at yourself, I can't, I'm dumb, I look crazy. But there's nothing wrong with you, it's just how you see yourself. Maybe the mirror is broken, not you. The world is made of mirrors, I've just decided the world is made of mirrors. And when you look at people, you see yourself in our eyes. I'll prove it to you. I went to buy a phone, I was in East Texas. There was this racist woman looking at me. Now, how do you know that she's racist? Because it's East Texas, maybe, kind of, I don't know. But, sorry, I apologize. I walk in, she doesn't even work there. She's looking at me, ew, why is he here, And I'm looking at her face and I hated how she saw me. I'm looking at her eyes and I started to doubt my own worth. And I'm thinking, what is wrong with me? I go to the restroom, I look at myself in the mirror and I see this tall, dark, handsome, GQ down to the socks, young Denzel Washington. I said, pose on him. No. I said, but James, there's nothing wrong with you. But if it's not me, it must be her. I walked back out on that stage and I just could look at her and smile and say, that's okay. Too much chocolate to give you diabetes anyway, boo. There are some broken people in this world. There are broken mirrors in this world. Yes, they have a big house, but they can't call it home. Yes, they're getting a new phone, but no one's reaching out on the other end. I mean, sure, they can dial the numbers, but they'll never know their true calling. You say, well, she's getting this, and he's getting that. First off, you've got to stop comparing yourself to broken people, right? Think about that. You want love from somebody who doesn't love themselves? You want respect from somebody who doesn't respect themselves? What are we talking about? You say, well, they're getting new clothes, and they're getting a new car, and they're getting new shoes. Let them get new shoes. I mean, they'll never end up leaving a footprint on the world anyway. Is what you see what you are? Yes, but you have to see it for yourself. You have to see yourself becoming something amazing even when other people cannot. I think it's a vision test. Who has eyeglasses? Raise of hands, because I don't have mine on. Okay, cool. I bet if you were to give your eyeglasses to somebody else in this room, it wouldn't work out. You'd give them to them, ugh, is this what you see? Girl, you blind. Ew, you blind. Why is that? They were prescribed for you. They were made for you. They were meant for you. I think dreams, goals, vision, opportunity, these things were made for you. And when you try to give it to other people, it doesn't work out. I bet you try to share your dream with somebody. That's what you're going to do? No, you can't do that. That's too hard. I can't see it. You can't see it because it wasn't meant for you. It was made for me, and that's why you can't see it. And I'm asking you, what do you see tonight? Is what you are what you see? You're going to have to see it for yourself. They saw you as a failure. You have to see yourself as a masterpiece in progress. They saw you as a loser. You have to see yourself as making a comeback, being recharged, being transformed, and making an impact. Did you see what I did there, right? What do you see? You have to see right now that you're just in the process. Whatever you're going through, school, work, problems, inner demons you're facing, that's just part of your process. You are not a final product. And if you can see past the process, your purpose is on the other end. Did you catch that? If you can see past the process, your purpose, watch this. Right now, you feel that life is telling you no. Now, dreams are telling you no. Now, success is telling you no. Now, opportunity is telling you no. But don't you see there's more to now than no? I mean, even when you spell now, you don't stop at no until you get a W. Oh, my God. No. You just have to get through right now. Whatever you're going through, I know that it sucks, but I want you to get through right now. And when you get through now and you look back on your life, you'll see that you've won. I mean, because when you spell now and look at it backwards, it spells one. You just have to get, you'll catch it. You just have to get through right now. Is what you see what you are? Yes, but you have to see it for yourself. If you can see it, you can be it. A third question. If you want to grow, what are you willing to let go? Pain? Ah, it burns, ah! I don't know why you'd hold on to something that burns you. Some of you have been holding on to some people that have been burning you. Are you holding on to the past because you think it makes you stronger? I'll never let it go. I'll never forgive him what he said to me. I'll never, they took that, I'll never forgive him. Look how strong I am because I'm holding this grudge. Are you holding on to bitterness and frustration because it distracts you from being accountable for your own happiness? Let it go. A caterpillar could say, this is how I think caterpillars move. A caterpillar could say, I did a lot of research on this. This is how they do the move. I hate being a caterpillar. This is stupid, man. I've been on this tree all day. This is dumb. I hate me. Why am I here? You may be a caterpillar right now, but you weren't born to be a caterpillar. You're just in the process of your life. You weren't born to be a caterpillar, but you grow through the process and you transform your life. You were born to be majestic. And it's not an overnight success. It's a transformation. And soon you don't look the same. Soon you don't hang in the same neighborhood. I've never seen a caterpillar and a butterfly hanging out together. I'm asking you who you're hanging with. When you look at a butterfly, you never call it a caterpillar. It's the same organism, essentially. You never see a butterfly say, ooh, caterpillar. No, we need to go back to recess because you're not smart. I don't know. We're doing shapes next week. But why is that? I'm saying that even when you go through this process, your name changes. What they used to call you at school or work doesn't match who you are today. I'm saying you go through the process. I said that wrong. You grow through the process. I'm saying that when you are transformed and really doing this thing, your old ways weren't meant for your new days. Can I tell you a story real fast? I'm in college at the time. I go back home on the weekend to Dallas, and I'm rummaging through, and I find some old shoes, some old Jordans. I said, oh, man, I love these shoes. Now, they were from junior high. They were three sizes too small, but they were in really good shape. And I said, what did I do? Tried them on. Jamming, I'm doing the Black Cinderella. I'm jamming my foot into these shoes. I can say that. I'm jamming my foot. I laughed. I lost 30 people over here when I did that. I'm jamming my foot into these things, and I'm just, my toes all crooked, and I said, okay, I'm going to go play basketball now. Worst idea ever. My legs jammed up. My knee kept buckling. I'm doing the electric slide and doing gang signs with my feet. I mean, it was really bad. But what happened? What happened? I outgrew the shoe. The shoe stayed the same size all those years, and I did not. And when you try to fit into something that does not fit you, it hurts you in the end. When you try to go back to something that does not fit who you are, it hurts you in the end. I wonder if friendships are the same way. Mindsets, old habits, old people, you try to go back and fit into situations, and if this is why it's causing you pain. This is uncomfortable, and you keep going back and keep going back. Some of your pain comes from you staying in that relationship you outgrew. I'm sorry, I won't touch that one. You're going to have to let it go. I'm saying tonight you're going to have to let go what you outgrow. Everything in your life that's slowing you down, tripping you up, you're going to have to let go. It does not fit. Some of you are too big hanging with small-minded people. Sorry about that. Sorry. I don't know if you brought them with you. Whoops, I got this awkward. It's going to be on the, oh, yeah, you know, he was talking about you. All right. Tonight, we answered three major questions. If you want to grow, you gotta let it go. Your old ways weren't meant for your new days, right? Is what you see what you are? Yes, but you gotta see it for yourself. I know your classmates can't see it. I know the people you hang out with, I know they can't see you becoming something amazing, but you have to see it for yourself. If you can see it, you can be it. And if you wanna be informed, that's okay, but being transformed means changing your life. You get a new chapter. You get to decide what happens next. As I close, I want to leave you with this. We see the caterpillar, right? And we see the butterfly and how amazing it is. But we never talk about what happens on the inside of the cocoon. No one knows the growth and the strife and the hardship and the pain and the suffering that happens on the inside of the cocoon. No one knows the real darkness on the inside of the cocoon except the caterpillar. In order to become majestic, the caterpillar has to go away for a little while. It has to be set apart for a little bit. It has to work on some things for itself. Maybe you need to turn your social media off for a little bit. Maybe you need to stop responding to every single text message and every single, well, she said, The transformation of your life happens you alone in the gym, you alone in the studio, you alone in the classroom, wherever it is, working on you, just you. In order to become majestic, you're gonna have to be okay with some darkness, growing in some darkness, grinding in some darkness. There might be some days when no one calls you, no one was there to help you. It's just you working on yourself, becoming the best version of you. Friends, I challenge you. I challenge you. After tonight, I hope you take your mess and you make it majestic. You have wings and you can fly.